It's living, it's living. So I said that what was happening in 1900s, 1994, I think it was, just pissed me off the national. So I said, I'm gonna write a song about it. Johnny Cash at the time couldn't get a record deal in Nashville. And I thought, well, no, I'm wrong. And I couldn't either. I mean, I thought, why should I be able to do it? Johnny Cash couldn't get a record deal in Nashville. They said I was too country for country. So I wrote this song as a letter to Merle Haggard. This will appeal to the DJs of country music. Mr. DJ, can't you please play a real country song? Where's your conscience? What's the problem? Hey, you gotta speak up and you gotta tell them what's wrong. Play Loretta or some Conway.
Yeah.
Hey! Ain't you please play a real country song? Well, that didn't work either, because I found out that the DJs of country radio were nothing but monkeys pushing buttons. They couldn't make any decision at all. They got things called music consultants that tell them what to play, when to play it, and how to play it, and how long to do it. So it didn't do any good to appeal to the music DJs, unless I gave them a lot of money. So, time passed. I was in the dentist's office. I looked down on the table there, and there was a National Enquirer. That's back in the 1999s. National Enquirer, right on the front page there, it said, things heard backstage at the CMAs. Country Music Awards. Well, that piqued my interest, so I thought, well, let me look at this. Because I knew that Waylon was on there, Merle was on there, and they had some awful shit on there, awful. And one of my favorite things heard backstage at the CMAs, I had to write a song about it. It was Waylon talking to Merle. I don't know who said it to who, but one of them turned to the other one when they seen a CMA shirt. CMA should stand for Country My Ass. Don't call me a country singer, please. By today's standard, I am not a country singer. I'm Ameripolitan. Thank you, sir. I'm Ameripolitan. Ameripolitan. A-E-M-E-R-I-P-O-L-I-T-A-N. Mayor Paul, we got an award show that we honor people like, well, the Reverend Horton Heat. That's right, they're getting Keeper of the Flame. They already got Rockabilly Band 1 year. We honor people like Wanda Jackson, Junior Brown. Big Sandy's one Rockabilly Band and singer. So, High Noon, that's right, Keeper of the Flame, you got it. So there's a lot of folks we try to let people know about and keep in their minds. It ain't easy doing what we're doing against the mainstream. But when George Jones said, you know, I love that song you do, Country My Ass, I want to record it, my heart started beating. He goes, but no. But my wife don't think that my fans would appreciate me cussing in a song. After all my life doing music, I've never cussed on a record. I said, I understand that, Mr. Jones. So I just honored that you even liked the song. He said, I like the song, I hope you keep doing it, because you're saying what I feel. And if I feel it, other people feel it. So I want you to keep doing that song. So that's why I do it. But now I always hear George since he passed. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
To reach your song, I do believe. Pain took the soul, and one means a whole lot. I can see how you can let me spin around. And if they were here now, I think it goes, what the fuck? 3 miles.